Hey guys, I'm Panos, and in this lesson we learn about one of the most popular microtonal blues scales. So grab your guitar. I call it Majorish 4-7, because as you'll see, besides the Majorish 3rd and 5th degree, it also consists of the 4th and 7th degrees, which differentiate it from other blues scales. This scale looks like the blues scale you already know, but it isn't. So, for the sake of the experiment, just for today, put away what you already know and let's start fresh in this new framework. So, the overall sound of this scale is a Majorish one. That's why it is played over major chords, and sometimes over 7th flat 10 chords. This scale can also be played over power chords, or even a drone, in order to give that Majorish blues texture. Okay, let's see the notes that make up the scale. The first note is of course the root, the tonic of the scale. There is nothing new to say about it. It's the most stable note of the scale, so be careful with the vibrato you apply. You don't want it to go sharp. The next note is the third degree. This one is the most important note of the scale, since it gives the Majorish tonality to the scale. This note generally has the largest variation margin, but in this case, the actual note you need to hit at the end of the bend lives in the upper area of the third pitch complex. Every bluesman does it a little differently, but I'll show you some examples so you can understand what I'm talking about. In the next episode, we'll see some ways to emulate this bend of the third degree using various techniques. Also keep in mind that bluesmen frequently use in major key blues songs the neutral third as an important note too. We'll talk about it in another episode, since we're focusing on the Majorish third for now. As I said in the previous lesson, bluesmen also play passing notes in between important blue notes, so standard minor thirds can also appear. Don't get confused, they are just another shade of the third degree complex, and are not coming from another scale. So, the next note is the fourth degree of the scale. This one lives in an area just a little higher than the standard fourth. Let's see some examples. I'll skip the fifth for now, and I'll show you the seventh degree of the scale. This one occurs in two distinct areas. The most frequent blue 7th note lives a little higher than the Western 7th, and sometimes is played as high as the neutral 7th, the pitch between the standard minor and major 7th notes. Here are some examples. Also, another shade of a 7th degree is used, the one just a little lower than the standard 7th. You can approach it by bending the 5th or the major 6th. Most of the time, this low 7th note is followed by the major 6th, but that's not necessary. The scale we study today doesn't include the 6th, so let's ignore it in the following examples. These 4 degrees we covered make a tetratonic scale that produces a specific blues texture. Now, let's talk about a special note you can add to this scale, the augmented 4th. This one usually lives in the area just below the standard augmented 4th, so to approach it, you bend from the 4th up to the augmented 4th area. Let's see some examples. Now, let's add the 5th degree in the scale. This note lives a little lower than the standard 5th, but the 12th tet 5th is also frequently used. It is almost always approached with a bend from the 4th of the scale. It can also be reached with a bend from the diminished 5th, which results in a different sound. Let's see some examples. Thank you. The fifth degree, played as an important note, gives a new flavor to the previous scale, as every note you add. I suggest you practice this pentatonic scale independently from the previous tetratonic one, with or without the augmented fourth. In my opinion, each combination of notes gives a slightly different texture, so it's in your artistic choice to play the one you like each time. Now, let's see some phrases over a 12-bar blues that are characteristic of this scale. If you want to practice over this backing track, you can download it from the link in the description below. See you next time!